More of both entertainment and sports today.
Keep God first.
Watch me on entertainment and sports today.
Stay tuned for entertainment and sports today.
A big winner in the chat. We want this to be fun. We want this as a big night of fun. It's a great evening for people to see.
No.
Happy St. Patrick's Day here. We're live at the Tam O'Shanter Inn. This inn we've done almost every year. 100-year history. Was there last year? Was the 100th anniversary? Remember our show from then? This is the 101st anniversary of the Tam O'Shanter. And we have the manager again has been so kind to us, John Lindquist. He's going to tell you a little bit about the history. Just off the top of my head, they all started out with Walt Disney way back when, the 1920s. They used this as their commissary.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've been here in Atwater Village since 1922. That makes us a 101 this year. So excited to be celebrating the next 100 years of this restaurant after we got through the 100-year celebration last year. Like he said, Walt Disney was our regular customer. He was here 5 days a week because when they built his studio down on Hyperion, which is just a stone's throw from this restaurant, there was no commissary. And there was no viable restaurant in the area except us. So he was here holding court, making sure that his Imagineers were here doodling, making sure that they were doing what they were supposed to be doing on his lunch break every single day. So that's always a fun bit of history. He's got his own table here, table 31, the most requested table at the Tam O'Shanter. But we're here celebrating St. Paddy's Day today.
And that's the original table, same wood and everything?
Yep. It's the same. Well, it's not the same wood. We've had to replace the wood a few times. Granted, it's almost 100 years old, that table. We replaced it a few times, but the Imagineers came in about 10 years ago and did some etchings on the top of the table, which is actually the original attractions in Disneyland. So you've got some dinosaurs, you've got some spaceships from Tomorrowland. And what Walt Disney did was when he sat here having lunch, on the back of cocktail napkins, he would doodle these things. And these things turned out to be those attractions that are actually imprinted into the table now. However, those Tam O'Shanter napkins, they reside in the Disney Family Archives up in San Francisco. They will not even give us a copy of them. We've seen the pictures, but they won't give us the copies. They belong to them. Because that's his original piece of work.
Now, after Disney, was it like Fanny Arbuckle and Laurel and Hardy, or who else was a?
Fanny Arbuckle drank in everybody's bar in Los Angeles, so he was definitely here. But we had Fanny Arbuckle. We had John Wayne here. When he was shooting Griffith Park, and they would come down here a lot. So he's got his own table, table number 15, second most requested table in the restaurant.
John Wayne.
John Wayne.
Wow, unbelievable. Yep. And then tell us about the brief history of how it went to a Lowry's owned, and it became the longest running family owned restaurant, and in the same, some are family owned, but they moved. Yours in the same location since 1922, yep. I think.
You got it, yeah. So since 1922, we've been family owned and family run by the Franks and the Vandekamps, the two partners. They were both brothers-in-laws when they started the restaurant. They started this as their first restaurant. We were coming from selling potato chips downtown, but we bought this piece of property in 22, and that's when we opened up the Tam O'Shanter. We were a roadside stand. We were selling hot dogs and hamburgers. We still have hamburgers on the menu, and of course those potato chips that we're famous for as well. But in 1922, when we opened up this restaurant, they were the people who started Lowry's. So the Franks and the Vandekamps, we own Lowry's, and this has always been the Lowry's restaurants. So this was the first one they ever opened. In 1937, we were getting ready to open the prime rib. And the prime rib is famous for something called that seasoning salt, that Lowry's seasoning salt. which is behind me here on the tables. But that seasoning salt was actually mixed here, the first batch of it, here in our garage in 1937. In 1938, we opened that famous one-dish restaurant, Lowry's the Prime Rib.
That's before the actual Lowry's restaurant. You mixed the seasoning here.
We made it here. This was their test kitchen. So after we opened the Prime Rib in 1938, we became synonymous with, obviously, that seasoning salt that started life right here at this restaurant.
That's amazing. And then also tell us about that you import the corned beef only 2 months of the year for St. Pat.
Well, we have corned beef and cabbage on the menu for the 2 months preceding and after St. Patty's Day. This St. Patty's Day, we've got 1,200 pounds of corned beef. And I can't tell you how many heads of cabbage we have back there because I lost count.
So now over the years, you had more and more people find out about this place, and more and more companies come here, and are they like celebrities? And
yeah, absolutely. We still have a celebrity clientele. We keep it very hush-hush about our celebrity clientele. They love this place, and they love it for one reason. There's no paparazzi here. We're a little bit out of the way. We're not in Hollywood. We're not like Musso and Frank's. They can find a little booth and hide out here. So we've had, you know, Steven Spielberg's been in here. You can, you know, any given day at the bar, you can usually spot somebody that you're like, I know that face. I know that face. And sure enough, they're a celebrity and they want to hang out here at the Tam because it's nice and quiet.
That's awesome. So anyways, this is a place to hang out. Now for St. Patrick's Day, you build a tent and you have authentic Irish bands that perform here.
Yeah, so I had three bands today playing. Howl & Wake just got off stage, and we are up with the Plowboys right now. So the Plowboys, they're going to play till about 7 o'clock tonight, and then I've got we've got Whiskey Sunday closing out the day today, which I'm really excited about them. They're going to go on about 8 o'clock tonight in the main entertainment tent.
And then throughout the year, though, even though it's not St. Patrick's Day, you still get a big turnout of people coming out here all the time?
Yeah, absolutely. We're probably busier than we've ever been. We're busier than we were pre-pandemic, which is great. So business has bounced back, recovered quite nicely since what happened in 2020. And every first Friday of the month, the Plowboys do play here in our bar. And then we have music on the first and third Fridays of every month. So we've got a big crowd for that. Not only that.
Oh, so even throughout the year you have live entertainment.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Live entertainment, like I said, the first and third Friday of every month here at the Tam. That we've got a lot of whiskey in this joint too as well. 700 whiskeys on the whiskey list. So we have a lot of people coming in just to see the whiskey collection, just to taste a few of those great drams.
Yeah, it's like a museum here. If you get a chance, you got to come down. Now, what's the best? Should they call for reservations or should they go online? What's better?
Yeah, absolutely. You can call the restaurant here, 323-664-0228, or you can go online to our website at tamoshanter.com. And you can make reservations right through Open Table, the company app that we use for that.
Well, John, thank you so much for having us. We're going to take you down to 10 to show you a couple of clips of these amazing, authentic Irish bands. This is the place to come not only for St. Patrick's Day, but for the entire year. If you want the best food, this is the place to come. We'll be right back.
Hey, what's your name? What are you doing in here? And who cares?
Yeah,
what's your name?
Jimmy Panette.
Do you come here often?
Occasionally, but it's a trip because I live in Temple City.
That's a bit of a drive for you to get here, huh?
Yeah, San Gabriel. I first stopped at Matt Denny. You ever heard of Matt Denny?
I have not.
In Arcadia. They're having two bands tonight. And so I stopped by to say hi to them, and then I left and came here.
Well, I think this is a premiere for the Southern California. Absolutely.
I've never seen so many Irish people.
And here we are live from the Tam O'Shanter Inn celebrating their 101st birthday. Here we are in the entertainment portion of the show. They have three great bands here today, here in the tent, with great, authentic Irish music. As you see behind me here, Whiskey Sunday. This is their sixth year doing this here. Whiskey Sunday with authentic band. Stay tuned for more, some highlights from the concert here at the Tam O'Shanter's 101st St. Patrick's Day celebration. We'll be right back.
lies awaiting in the bay. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
dance floor. Del Taco, after party.
That's it. That's a wrap. We're out of here.
Good night, everybody.
All right, we're ready. Ciao.
Tam O'Shanter. There you have it. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
It's a very good point. I mean,
entertainment and sports today.